There she is. Let's get her.
I'm all for it, but she beats us every time.
Let's get her. She's giving the Sin Gang a bad name.
I'm gonna give you a bad name if you don't go get her.
But she keeps beating me with her Bible. I'm no match for her.
We should challenge her to a showdown. Whenever she draws her Bible, I'll sneak over and grab it.
That's pure evil.
I love it.
Ain't you had enough, dirty dog?
After today, you ain't gonna mess with the Sin Gang no more.
You ready?
Drop!
When the enemy comes in like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord will make him gone.
How did she do that?
Yeah, I thought we had ya.
I don't just know the Bible, I use the Bible and I know it in my heart. You can think about it while you're in jail.
Must have water.
We're almost to Whistle Creek. I'm so hungry, too. I can't believe those sneaky prairie dogs got away with all our biscuits. I slept with one eye open all night long.
Well, it's not by our power or by might, but it's by God's Spirit that I can keep going.
You hear that? Well, I'll be a monkey in a cowboy hat. It's Whistle Creek. Hand me a canteen and I'll get you some water. That means the town is close. Let's rest up and go explore the town.
Whoop, 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 whoop. I sure do feel better now. Hey, Dusty, I think I found a place for us to stay tonight.
Look at this. I was at the general store, and I saw this.
That's us! Right on the cover, hot diggity dog. My, my, my. We sure are good looking.
No, don't you see? News is spreading about the mayhem going on in Rowdy Town. Mary Big Pants is making a move, and the whole town is suffering. It even mentions the Sin Gang.
Oh, them? I locked them up.
Yeah, but they didn't stay locked up. They escaped. Now they teamed up with Mayor Big Pants and Lousy Buck.
This ain't good. This ain't good at all. It's like everyone's against us.
Well, don't you know? My friend Jesse Names has a story about that.
There, come get by the fire. My name's Jesse Names, and boy, do I have a doozy of a story for you out here on the range. God's people, the Israelites, were living in Egypt as slaves. Sun up to sun down, the mean old Pharaoh put them to work each and every day. But even though they were downright miserable, God never left them. He knew that they needed help, and he sent Moses and Aaron to help them to the promised land. Moses and Aaron listened to God and went to Pharaoh to tell him that it was time to let God's people go. Pharaoh didn't care. He liked having slaves around doing all the work for him, so he refused to hear what they said. Moses didn't know what to do, so he prayed and asked God for help. God reminded Moses that he would never leave him and that God would save his people. God told Moses and Aaron to go talk to Pharaoh again, so that's exactly what they did. They said, let God's people go. But Pharaoh's answer was still the same, a big N-O, no. God told Moses and Aaron that Pharaoh would ask them to perform a miracle. So Aaron took his walking stick, threw it on the ground in front of Pharaoh, and it turned into a mean old snake. That didn't bother Pharaoh none. He still refused to obey God's command to let his people go. It was time to take some drastic measures. Moses then met Pharaoh at the Nile River and asked him one more time to let God's people go. But wouldn't you know it, he didn't listen. So God told Moses that Aaron would use the walking stick to strike the river. And when he did, he turned it into blood. You'd think that would be enough to convince Pharaoh. But no siree, Pharaoh stayed stubborn and refused to let God's people go. God had Moses try to convince Pharaoh 9 more times to prove that he was for his people. God brought punishment on Pharaoh and the Egyptians, and boy, they sure did suffer. Picture this. God sent thousands of frogs, hippity-hopping all over the town, the whole place smelling worse than an old book. Then, swarms of gnats and flies buzzing around everybody's head. It didn't get better from there either. I'm talking animals dying left and right, boils all over their skin, hail falling from the sky, locusts flying around, darkness for days, and by golly, even death. Now, the whole time that this was happening, the Israelites were waiting and wondering when they would be set free. They knew that God hadn't left them, and that one fine day they would see the promised land. After all this crazy mess, Pharaoh finally had enough. He let God's people go. And as they were heading out of town, God sent a cloud to lead them by day and a fire to lead them by night. God had never left them while they were in Egypt, and he would never leave them on their long journey to the promised land. Bye for now. See you next week.
I ain't never heard that part of Moses' story before.
Sure does sound crazy, right? It sounds like Egypt was buck wild with all those crazy plagues that God sent. But he helped his people escape Egypt.
God really does keep proving over and over again that he's with us.
And he's never going to leave us.
I am hungry.
For the word of God?
That, and I sure would love some frog leg stew right about now.
Ew.
Book! Book!
Look what you needin'.
What I need is for you to go round up some more people to go to work.
I just met the meanest old bunch of people. They're pure evil.
You'd like them. I can use them. Long as you don't care. They just broke out of jail.
I'm the mayor. I'll pardon them to do my dirty work if I get all that gold.
Okay then.
That Calamity Jane sure can cook.
That was the best liver and onions I've ever had.
And the frog leg stew?
There's a square dance. Come on, let's go.
Hard pass.
But why?
Well, I don't know how.
Dancing's easy. You just move to the left, shuffle to the right, then turn in a circle till you win a ball.
That sounds awful.
No, it's fun. Let's go to the hoedown.
Wow, Dusty and Dallas seem to be having a great time in Whistle Creek. I'm glad they could get to rest up and have some fun before they head back out the trail to find Tumbleweed Canyon. And it seems like the town of Whistle Creek is full of all kinds of folks, especially that news reporter, Miss Eau Claire. She told Dusty and Dallas a story from the Bible. In that story, how did God help his people, the Israelites, escape from Egypt? By sending plagues or sending cowboys? That's right, by sending plagues. God allowed bad things to happen to Pharaoh and the people of Egypt so that they would finally allow the Israelites to leave. No matter what crazy things happened to God's people, he never left them. That story reminded Dusty and Dallas of how God had never left them when they were trying to escape from Rowdy Town. And it helped them see that God will be with them on the trail no matter how crazy things come their way. Just like God never left the Israelites, we can trust him, so he'll never leave us either. That's why we need to know today. So let's all get up and worship. Bye.
If you're free, prove it. If you're free, prove it. If you're not lost. can't tell them. If freedom is free, if they say it is, where we go, where they displaying it? We wanna start with a chain scene. It's the promised land up for the taking. No one is free on them slaves, just only a slave with enslavement. Egypt is still in our nation. They change his face, his face. Yeah, I'ma need more than they paying me. I don't need money, I need a key. I'ma need legal and liberty, free and the hidden invisibly. I'd rather die than be steeping in tyranny. Just like I got it, I give it like war. Race to the nations, no hating, you know. We in the great and we be in the race. So you love it, your neighbor, they go little.
So come freedom.
partners, I hope you guys are ready because we're going to see who can say this week's Bible verse the fastest, boys versus girls style.
Just so you know, I'm going to win.
Ha! You wish.
Now, whichever one of you can find the Bible verse and say it first wins. Ready, set, take it to me, Feeblin 7. Go.
2 Timothy 1:7, God has not given me a spirit of fear, but of power, love, and a sound mind.
Yay! We have a winner! All right, let's play another game.